Good morning, everyone. Today I'm here with Darwin Durney, our Chief Flood Mitigation Officer. And we're at the Newcastle Beach, and I want to discuss a really important update today. Darwin, can you tell me what we have today to update?
Heather, last year in the spring, the federal government announced with Minister Champagne here at the Royal Tyrrell Museum, the $22 million contribution from the federal government towards our $55 million program. And it's taken a while, through about a year, for us to finally ink the deal with Infrastructure Canada and finalize it so that we can get going on all our projects. So it's very, very exciting time, a huge milestone, and I'm really happy to have achieved that today. So what I'd like to do is ask that you unveil the first project sign in the valley, and I'll give you a hand.
Okay, awesome. Wow, so there is our first sign that the community will see. So this is a great opportunity, and now we can start planning and becoming a reality, correct?
Absolutely, we'll see these kind of signs throughout the valley. We'll put a little tab on the bottom to describe the actual program. Yep. Here it'll say the Newcastle Beach Conveyance Improvement. Anyways, we'll see lots of them up and down the valley, from storm ponds to trail systems that we're going to
see. So we need to have everybody just keep watching for these signs. So speaking of projects, can you update me on the urban forest project? What's happening with that one?
Oh, certainly. We're making great progress on that, and that's going to become so key to our climate adaptation. Not only do the trees sequester carbon, they help keep it cool.
And they make it beautiful.
Absolutely. 15,000 trees have been mapped throughout the valley by our team. We found that over half of the trees are over 50 years old, which kind of makes sense for poplars and just how they life out. We're going to be looking at many different species throughout the valley and augment that with the tree farm.
Okay, Darwin, thank you so much for that update. I really, really appreciate it. As we stand here at the Newcastle Beach, we get the benefits of making room for the river, and that's really what it's all about. And we're just fortunate we're able to enjoy other things like the beach and stuff from it. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Wherever we can, we're going to leverage the opportunities of this so that the residents and visitors alike can enjoy the side benefits of what we do when we make room for the river.
Absolutely. I know it's not perfect. I know it's not 100% yet. But we got to get people to respect that we're not, you know, we don't want driving. Like, we've got kids over there already. What time is it? 10 o'clock in the morning, out enjoying the beach. We've got signs up showing where fishing is. So I just hope that people respect that, you know, these are here for a reason, right?
Absolutely. And so, we'll continue to incrementally improve things as we adapt to the usership. We're seeing the river and the beach used more than it's ever been in 20 years at least. And that's just great news. And the more that we can leverage the projects that we do under the flood program to the benefit of the valley and the residents and visitors alike, I think that's
and that's
success.
A, you know, when you see all the clearing and stuff, these are things that are all about making life better for the residents and our visitors. So thank you, everyone. Thank you for respecting the signs and everything that's going on. And just enjoy yourself. Have a great day. Take care and stay safe.